What's up, everybody, and welcome back for part 4 of Collision Course. This one is going to be called The Ship, and you'll see exactly why I've called it that later on in the video. Now, today's video is going to go a bit differently because when I recorded it, it didn't capture the mic, and so there's no running commentary over the video. So I've gone back in the editing phase, I've recorded over the video, and this is what you're hearing now. So I apologise for that. Today's part is a bit special. We've made some awesome discoveries in this part, which I don't want to spoil anything for you, but just wait and see and you'll see what I'm talking about. I also want to start off by saying thank you for the huge support. I understand it's not millions and millions of views overnight, but it's not what I expect. It is a bit of a dream of mine to make a YouTube channel that is successful, and so I basically want to play games and get them across to you guys, and so you can have as much enjoyment as I do when I play them. We've had more views than I would have expected on this kind of video, and also a couple of odd subscribers, which is really nice to wake up to. Now, I hope you've been following me in my last few parts. Obviously, part 1, Survive, it was called. Part 2, The Cave. And part 3, Drops and Trips. You might think why I named it that, but obviously there's a supply drop, and you know it's a bit trippy near the end. That's my thinking behind it. But obviously, I wasn't littered with supply crates. But in this one, that kind of changes. So hopefully so far in the first three parts, I've shown you guys a little bit what this game can offer, from the scenery to the enemies to little hidden secrets that you know you just randomly come across and you find. And I hope I've been sharing these experiences in a way which can be delivered quite well, really. I mean, I like to think that I've got a fairly decent PC. The footage you're seeing is of good quality. My narration doesn't suck too much. And, well, you're just getting a good vibe and the feel of the game. I mean, look at this pond. It does look amazing, the water. I can't believe the game's being released. There's early access and it looks as good as this. But you know, I'm relatively new to the whole PC Master Race kind of category. Before I had an Xbox One, other consoles are available. And this is where I found it. This is why I've named this part what I have named it. So at this point in, been playing for 2 minutes, I ran in this direction, didn't expect to find anything near as cool as this. I've seen a screenshot of this on Steam, one of the Steam screenshots, and I couldn't believe I found it. Just 2 minutes into the game, I ran in one direction, I didn't realise how close it was to the spawn. But yeah, I felt so lucky and over the moon. Just checking a few things out here and there. Obviously you can see a few fallen trees where the impact has taken them down. It's a pretty big wreckage. Not sure of the actual full size of the functional ship is, but this seems to be about half of it, judging by its width. Obviously not sure. I'm not a expert on ships, spaceships. I'm trying to find a way in. I'm trying to jump on various things. As you can see, I'm failing. Fallen tree? Maybe that could find a way up there. Just got to get onto this tree. Make sure nothing's around me, I guess. I'm trying to think of what I was thinking about at the time, because watching this now, I recorded this a few days ago, and I've made it. And so I might do some really random stuff, and I'll have no idea what I was thinking at the time. Okay, we're on the ship. Just going to check out the top of the ship, see if there's any kind of holes or weight stairs in or anything like that before we risk jumping down. Not sure what I was zooming in at then. Right, top floor of a ship. Let's have a look what we got here. Ooh, a supply crate. Now, if you watched my other video, you would have noticed that I had a machete in it and I found a supply crate and I thought you could only hit the lids off these with a weapon. But it turns out you can punch them off, which is very good. So in here I got a stamina boost, I got a survival suit cell, I got a health pack, and I got a pistol. And also I got a biometric scanner. The pistol's pretty cool, and what I'm showing here is I don't know if it uses the survival suit power or if it's separate ammunition or what that bar indicates or how you can get more This is your energy cell, which boosts your survival suit for your torch and your biometric scanner. Just looking at these buttons, I don't think I understand. And I used it. Not that I needed to. That was probably a waste. I'm probably complaining about how I already had a full survival suit and now I've just wasted that. This is my biometric scanner. It's pretty cool. That's pressing Q. That basically detects all organic life. Well, not all organic life, but dinosaurs in your immediate vicinity within 30 meters. So some pretty cool gadgets and gizmos and obviously a pistol, which I'm going to need. And I just found another supply crate. But I found another floor below me, which I want to... Oh, no. Typical. Let's get this stick. Yes, we always want a stick. A ranged weapon and a melee weapon. We always want that. It's a good combo. Just in case we have to last resort and beat a dinosaur with a stick. Okay, let's go for attempt number two, shall we? Level zero. Going in for the triple backflip. Double entente. Mercania flip duo. Will you make it? Will you make it? The pressure's on. He's not going to crack. Oh, and he misses. He flops it. He misses. He's pretty upset. He's going to hide under the... No, he's not. He's looking around, acting like nothing went wrong. He's cool and calm. He's collecting himself. He's going to go for attempt number three. He knows that there's going to be something in there, and he's not going to give up. He's never going to give up. Here he is. This is his third strike. If he doesn't do it this time, I'm not sure what he will do. He might just exit the game, I'm not sure. Oh, and he makes it! He makes it, perfect. 10 out of 10, and the judges are pleased. Ooh, and a door. Now, this could be interesting. We're not sure what's inside that door. It could be a cell. It could be the cockpit. We don't really know. RLU-3B. Romeo, Lima, Uniform. 3 Bravo. Now, obviously we know there are inmates and the like on the ship. And we don't know if it came from this ship or if this is part of our ship or what. We're not sure. But there's no way of opening that door. I did try using my action button on the door. Mostly in the crash site, there are a lot of crates which have been littered about the floor. Just going to have a look at all of them. See if we can bust into any of them, get some more nice resources. Let's use the stick. Oh, and you throw the stick. And you should have learnt your lesson from the other parts. Now, your stick is pretty much a spear, so I suggest you don't throw it at a metal supply crate. Got a health pack, we got some nice stuff in there. A repeat of what we got before, but that's okay. We don't mind. You can never have too much loot. Oh, and there's another one. This one seems a bit smaller, and the lid doesn't want to seem to come off. It's more decorative, let's say. But that's fine, because he's not going to give up. I'm not going to give up. Oh, he's giving up. Okay. That's fine, because we found this. Oh, that... Think about that now. That could be ammunition. Next time I open my inventory, I'm going to have a quick look at the pistol ammunition. Right. Just double checking. I've been everywhere. There could be more stuff to discover, but you don't know where it's going to be placed in these woods, so I'm sure I'll move on. So the crash site could build a bit of story, which is really, really exciting to find. Got a nice bit of loot from it, and hopefully if you guys want to, I'm not sure if it will be, you can go to the same place on your game and see if it's there, and loot it if so. But it might not be, so you have to cut me some slack if it's not. Well, I apologise, but I got a pistol and you didn't. Nah. That's normal, that's meant to happen. Testing out my new biometric scanner. nice filter, nice something chat filter. Other phone-based apps are available. I'm not sure if I need to say this stuff, but I'm just going to say it just in case. A little drink of water. You guys might recognise, if you have been watching my other parts, you might not have. You know, I've been skipping through it saying this is boring and rubbish, and that's how I got my views. But I have been there before, and nice little bit of fresh water. It doesn't actually hurt you when you drink. You can't kill yourself from drinking that. Go right to the spaceship. See if I can... Oh! What was that? Oh, sorry, Zachary. Oh, it's wrapped. Oh. I got it. That should have been enough rounds. Kind of wasted a whole clip on him then. But he's dead, and that's the first dinosaur killed. Woohoo, let's have a celebration. He looks quite pleased about the matter, doesn't he? Lying down on the floor. And there's another comet. Meteor strike. Let's just retreat back to the ship for shelter. No, well, I can't check if I had more ammo from that little bit, but because obviously I wasted loads, but just had health back. Health's gone back up, which is good. It works. That's a good thing. Ready for dinosaur number two. I can take on anything now. I'm invincible. I can take on a T-Rex or Stegosaurus or any other dinosaur. I used to know a lot more dinosaurs when I was younger. I mean, everyone used to love dinosaurs when they were younger. Well, unless that was just me. But not anymore. Now I just know the main ones. Just gonna do a bit more checking. Just letting myself calm down from the shock that was the raptor. Just checking the ship a bit more, just acting like I wasn't scared. Like, yeah, no, I just wanted to inspect the back of the ship for jet engines. Well, no, I was probably still pooing my pants from that raptor. Not sure if the gunshots attract more dinosaurs or not. So, got to keep an eye out. And there I see another raptor. So the shots may have attracted the other raptor. You've tried that before. What are you doing? Silly man. Right. So yeah, that raptor is obviously moving towards the direction which I fired my bullets at. So I'm not going to engage him. I don't want to risk it in case I pull the trigger and it's like because I don't have ammunition. So I'm going to try and sneak past this one. I did really want to get within 30 metres and check if the biometric scanner, which you can see now, was working, but I didn't want to get close, that close, because I thought that might be too close for him to see me. So I can see him there, and he's walking this direction. No, can't pick up my biometric scanner. Obviously, that's way past 30 metres, but I was worried that if I got any closer than that, then he'd see me. Where's he gone? I can't see him. Probably best if we left him alone. Ah, there he is. So, I'm happy with that. Happy with the loot I've got. I feel set and ready. Oh. I have no idea. This game is just filled with randomness. That's good. Keeps you on edge. Keeps your mind ticking over, you know, puts you in that frame of mind for surviving. Always constantly aware of your surroundings, very observant of your surroundings. I look a bit lost at the moment. Come on, let's go. Let's go in a direction. Okay, so moving on, As you can see, this is a slightly different biome, less fauna and shrubbery on the ground. But it's a nicely littered with trees. Builds enough shade so that you still feel like you are in a place that isn't easily recognisable, but in an open place where you can see relatively far. Just constantly checking behind me, I'm not sure if that raptor's found me. Now once again, if you've been watching my parts on YouTube and following the series, you'd recognise that place down there of the lava which I'm aiming at, and I'm probably at the moment telling you some commentary on how I died there in a lava pool when a T-Rex was chasing me. I was running away from the T-Rex and then I jumped over what I thought was a lava river, thinking, oh, that T-Rex won't jump to come get me. And it wasn't a lava river, it was just a bit of hardened molten lava, like rock, effectively. And it followed me over there and killed me. And you'd be able to see that in the other video, which is quite entertaining. There's a lot of yelping and wailing from me as I'm chased across by a T-Rex that I can't outrun, because every now and then I look behind me to see if he's still chasing me. This game is so peaceful. Such a nice place, isn't it? Sunny. It's got some nice background music. Some monkey lemur things in the trees. Some owls or something going boop, boop, boop in the background. Probably not owls, obviously, but or lemurs for that matter. Other monkeys are available. People who are experts on monkeys will probably tell me that a lemur isn't a monkey and it's some kind of primate something else, like a monkey, but not a monkey. And this is the volcano. Now, it might have been a good idea to go look at the top of this volcano, and I might do it in another part of the series. There's so much to explore, and at the time I was probably just thinking, oh yeah, I want to find me a T-Rex that I can kill, yeah. I don't know what I was thinking, to be honest with you, but volcano could be something interesting to explore. Also, the highest point in the map might be a good place to explore. I've heard a few rumours about something being up on top of a mountain. I'm not too sure. I don't know what I'm checking now. Checking a rock, yeah. Looking at a rock. Looking at... Okay. Let's keep moving. Now there, the reason why I'm doing that is because I thought it was like some kind of spit over a campfire. Somewhere they're cooking something. But turns out it wasn't. It wasn't, sorry. It wasn't. It was. They wasn't. Okay. So we got a river coming up. We want to cross the river. I'm paranoid again, thinking something's following me. If you watch my other videos, and I understand, you know, I know I keep saying if you watch my other videos, but if you have watched my other videos, you've noticed that I've been killed from absolutely nowhere. Like, it'd be raptors, and I'll give it that, there were raptors, but they just sneak up on you from nowhere. So we need to cross this river. Now we need to find the thinnest stretch of water, the shallowest stretch of water, and a place with not a lot of current. Now this place looks pretty good, and we're going to go in. We're going to go straight in, under the water, on the surface of the water, and the other side. Look at that. That is survival tip 146. Now I like it over here, because we're in the shade here. There's something about this game when you're in the shade. It looks... Oh, it just looks cold, but at the same time, you feel like you're in, you know, you're in shelter. It's that dark, it's that dense. It's nice. Yeah, I still seem really paranoid. Almost dark enough for your torch. Because you move so slowly through this dense, large forest, really, the map feels huge, and the map probably is huge. I don't even know the boundaries of the map. I haven't explored the boundaries of the map. Every time, every playthrough I've done, I have no idea where I end up, and I have no idea where I've been for that matter. I mean, I could have been 200 meters to my 2 o'clock now, and I wouldn't have known that until I went there again. I could be right next to the spawn, obviously I'm not. Well, I wouldn't have thought so. But I could be right next to the spawn and I wouldn't know about it. Just gonna get out of the swamp ambience music there. Very loud, very distracting. Too many flies as well, too many flies biting me. I really do suggest you guys head onto Steam and give us a go for yourself. Because, I mean, I can't do it justice, but hopefully I'm showing you a little bit of a taster. A little bit just to get you on there and just think, well, he's a bit of a fool. He ran this way. Why would you run that way when you could run this way? There was clearly something in them woods over there. Why didn't he go there? So you can do it yourself. And you can die by a rap to yourself and see how it feels. Because there are caves in the game. It could be an avalanche of something, or it could be kind of a noise distraction for the game to spawn dinosaurs in your vicinity, you know, in your zone. I'm not sure what it is, but I'm sure as the game progresses and more updates are released, it will become clear. And I keep looking back up at that place where the dust is, because I think that something's going to change there. I'm going to see something disappear or something appear, and then I was going to go check it out. I'm in the shade of the mountain here. Yeah, it's almost dark enough to be night time. So I'm just keeping my torch on. Just so I can see where I'm going. Right. What I want to do here is ascend this mountain. I want to go to the top. I want to see what's at the top. Now, I don't make it as far as the top because I give up hope, and it's so slow to run up hills of such a steep gradient, so I do kind of sack it off and just think, oh, I'll show it in another episode. Now, I just saw something that I didn't see the first time playing it. I thought I saw a dinosaur. But it probably wasn't. It probably was just a lighting. Yeah, I think it was just a lighting arrow or something. A little blue thing rolling away from me, suspicious. Someone's here. Yeah, there's all these different locations on the map which just build a different kind of feeling. You know, it sounds ridiculous because obviously maps do have different kind of areas which make you feel differently. I mean, even this. It's a different feeling to being in dense woods, to a different feeling to being in a swamp, or, you know, in the middle of the ocean. It's kind of derelict up here, kind of desolate. And you kind of don't want to stay here. just checking for any silhouettes of dinosaurs that are following me up. Just going to cross over this brow of this hill here. Have a look. Look at that view. Look at that. Beautiful. Beautiful. Look at that. Now, here I was like, yeah, let's climb the mountain. Let's go up there. Let's see what's up there. You mean the designers and they have to put something up there, you know, as like a kind of little Easter egg, a little tease for getting up there. Starting to slow down now. Get a bit tired. It's getting a bit steep now. And I'm thinking, this is going to take so long. So long to get to the top. If I do get to the top. I'm not going to waste time doing this. Nah, let's go down. Oh, okay. Sea sense, don't go up. Your doom is up there. Yeah, it's pretty dark now. Here comes the night cycle. It's when it's dark, it's pretty dark. I mean, you can see, but not very well. The map looks completely different at night, which is quite weird. It's just how stuff shines, maybe. Maybe it shouldn't shine as much, but I mean, rocks can shine because they're probably molten rocks. And I mean, I don't know, I'm not a geologist, but it makes sense for rocks to give off, reflect a little bit of light. Well, these kind of rocks anyway, with this kind of skin. The dirt might be a bit too radiant for dirt. But I'm not an expert on dirt. So what do I know? Now I think I recognised this river from before. To my, yeah, down in that direction, to my right now, is a river. And on Drops and Trips episode, I found that river. And I went down that river, and swam along the river. And then I got up from the river, and ran through some spores. And, yeah, I was put to this other kind of dimension place. Seen a raptor there. He looks like he's meditating or something. Anyway. And yeah, and I got transported to this kind of other realm. And I didn't really like it there, let's say. So I didn't want to go down there. Especially, I didn't want to trigger that raptor. So let's slowly move away. Okay, let's go towards it. There we go, let's move away. Let's head this way. See what we can find up here. Haven't been this way before. Anything could happen. You could just turn around a corner and see anything, you know. It's just completely new to me. It's a thrill. Now, I'm using my torch all the time at night, which probably isn't the best idea, but you kind of want to see where you're going, especially when you're exploring. Now, your torch uses your survival suit power, which can only be... I believe it does recharge slowly over time, but for a quick boost, you need to have a supercell. And obviously that supercell I used for no reason back at the ship. I don't want to go down there. That is a long way down. So currently, I believe I'm working on fumes as a... another comet, as you can see. And bang. quick. Let's get into some kind of survival location where we can hide away from this blast. Here it comes. Struggling to breathe, it's so dusty. Where are we gonna hide? Where are we gonna hide? Oh, that is a good idea, isn't it? A tree. Let's crouch behind a tree, turn our torch off, and act like we're safe. Now, my ideas aren't the best ideas. This dust and this cloud of smoke, or whatever it is, doesn't actually hurt you, despite your guy breathing quite heavily. But yeah, for dramatic effect and for realism, I've hid behind a tree. Obviously, that would do nothing, but that's all I could find. It's clearing now, so we can carry on. Found something on the floor over here. What is it? Ooh, what is it? Ooh, a stamina boost. Another one. Because I don't have any of them yet. Let's see what they do. Let's test one out. Let's use it, and then let's sprint. And it feels like the runs, the sprint speed's increased, but that just might be an illusion because I've been walking for so long. Oh, we're up to the last one. Oh, bloody hell. Get up, get up, get up, get up, get up. Shoot, 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 shoot. Oh. Oh. Rip. Now, Raptor got me. It didn't actually let me get up and shoot again, but that might have been because my body was sliding down a hill or saw something. I'm sure there's a reason behind it, but we can sort it. So, previous to what I've said before, it seems we have spawned with a pistol, which is good, which is some kind of progress we've made. We've saved it. If you've seen on my previous part, Crinosaurs, who design and produce and develop this game, said saving is coming soon, which is great, but this is enough for now, you know, to start off with a pistol so you're not starting from rock bottom again. That's what we want. Now, I want to say, I'm going to wrap it up here, guys. I want to say thank you for watching. Thank you for your huge support. Keep it coming if you can. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed, and you'll be included in more videos we're going to be doing. I mean, personally, I want to be doing Fort Honor, I want to be doing Wildlands. That'll probably be on the Xbox, however. Using an Elgato capture card. There are other brands available. And also loads of other games. So just subscribe, stay tuned. I'm going to be doing hopefully more new releases on Steam, smaller games like this, which don't have as many reviews. And like the video, you know, show your support, tell your friends if you can. If you like my British accent, then you can come for that. And I'll just, if you want it, I'll just do a recording of me reading you a bedtime story. I'm joking, but I will. But other than that, I want to wrap it up here. Thank you for watching. Thank you for all your support. From all the people at level zero, have a great day. Goodbye. See you in the next one.